Well, hi. Thanks for joining me in my shop for another session with this radio. And last video, I messed around with the tone control, volume control, feedback situation, and ended up with a, I don't know what to call it, sort of reconfigured, or maybe deconfigured is the right word, radio, which works a little better. But it's, in thinking about it yesterday after finishing in the shop here and pondering things, I think I can do better. I know this radio can produce good quality, let's call it hi-fi type sound, if it's fed the right signal. At the current arrangement, I think the bass reproduction is suppressed too much in this radio. So that's one of the things I want to fix, is make the fidelity a little bit better. I'm happy with the volume control working the way it does now, which is nice and continuous. So I disconnected wires going to this, I always forget this word, this tab at the back, tap. This tap on the back, that seemed to really fix things up. But you can see in the lower right there, I have Pete's sketch of the circuits that are involved down in here. And I stared at this diagram for quite a while last night, and this is what I think I want to do today to try to improve the sound quality. Basically, it's a two-step thing. First step is pretty simple. When I look at this diagram, and thank you again, Pete, for doing this, because it really does make things much easier to understand. Here you see the radio audio coming in and working its way to the volume control and then on to the amplifier. And this is all feedback stuff here, controlling feedback, which is coming in down here from the speaker, working its way through these circuits and switches and being applied to three different places here, which is on this tab, which is a tap, which is now disconnected, right into the bottom of the volume control, which is a mystery to me why it's done this way. Maybe that mystery just dropped off a little bit. And then it's also, depending upon the position of the switch, the feedback is fed through this small capacitor right into the output line on the far side of the volume. So I can only imagine that all this switching is going on here because this is also affecting the tonal response of the radio. And it doesn't affect it very well the way it was. So, as I mentioned, the current arrangement is that this wire is separated off of here. It's actually, in reality, in the radio, it's a wire and a lead from a resistor. Both are cut, so there's nothing happening here. So this whole thing is out of the picture right now. It's not doing anything. What is doing something, and not very much, is this circuit. As I switched in the last video, as I switched through the different settings of this switch, I could hardly perceive any change in anything. What I suspect I've done here is I've probably reduced the amount of feedback being supplied into the amplifier. Is it only relying now on this circuit with this very small capacitor here, 50 picofarad capacitor. So another thing I want, so here's what I want to do. So going back now. So here's the audio coming in. It's being selected between, based on the position of the switch, going through this capacitor, going through both capacitors, that kind of stuff. This capacitor is a 0.02, this is a 0.001 here. 0.001, that's pretty small. 0.002, everything is going through here. All the audio must go through this capacitor to get over to here. I want to increase the size of this capacitor. I suspect when we're in position 1 on the radio and things sound rather tinny, it's really just because this is too small. If you make this a 0.05, I think the fidelity will go way up coming in here. So that's one. Change that. 0.05, see what happens. In fact, I've got a decade capacitor box I can connect on here, and we can switch through and listen to what happens as we increase this capacitor here. The other thing I want to do is I want to, you know, this is so unusual what's going on here. Bottom of a volume control connected essentially to the secondary side of the output transformer. It's still scratching my head about exactly why they, who thought this up? I mean, who woke up one morning and went, I got it, and thought, you know, this is what they got. I don't know. I want to cut this wire here and connect this right to the chassis or to B minus or ground in the radio in the normal way a volume control would be connected. And lastly, the last thing I want to do is fiddle with this capacitor, and I guess this is really just an on-off switch, what's happening here. It's on or off in certain positions. So I want to make this, maybe I'll even connect from here straight, a permanent feedback line done appropriately to get the best advantage of the feedback. The best advantage is a reduction in distortion without knocking all the volume out of the radio. But too much feedback, too much negative feedback, I think you'll end up with pretty much nothing to listen to. So that's kind of a three-pronged approach here. Is it three? I think it's three. I won't even count them. The first one is the easiest one. In the radio, looking in the radio, this first capacitor here, this 0.02, is sitting in the open right here. Oops, right here. So what I'm going to do, let me grab it. Okay, so I have a decade capacitor box here, and it's not precise anymore, but I've checked it. It's generally okay. In other words, you start small and get bigger. So I can turn this, listen to the changes in the tone, and maybe pick a size here that's going to be good, stick it in. So I think, you know, I could put this in parallel around this capacitor, but then the lowest I could go is 0.02. Why would I want to go any lower? It's already very tinny, or somewhat tinny. Why would I want to go any lower? Because I'm totally wrong about everything I'm saying, and a smaller capacitor will make it sound better. Fat chance on that, so I don't think I'll do that. So that's what we'll do. So I think I'm going to set this to a very small size and put it in before I turn the radio on. This is indicating a polarity here, but I don't think any of these capacitors are big enough to be polarized. 0.2. I don't think there's any real voltage here anyway. Pretty big clip leads here. There we go. Okay, so we're going to give this a whirl. We're going to want to listen to some kind of program material, so I'll just tune in a shortwave radio station for now. Seems to me when you're doing tone checks, it's much better to listen to music, really, than listen to tones coming out of a tone generator. Okay, so the radio is switched off right now. I'm going to do this in position one. Position one, the input just comes through the switch and into this capacitor. So basically, this part of the circuit is ignored. So that's the thing to do, position one. What does position one do over here? Nothing anymore because it's disconnected. And position one here doesn't do anything. So there still remains a strong feedback connection into the bottom of the volume control. It's a weird arrangement. Volume's down. Let's apply the power. I think I'm on the 15 megahertz band. I think. Might as well turn on the signal generator. It'll probably be useful at some point. Better hook up an antenna. Keep stepping in front of the camera here. Let's change that. What do we got? Beautiful. When the volume's down, silence. No hum, no nothing. You wouldn't even know the radio's on. Okay, let's find us something to listen to here. Now the sun has been acting up the last week or so. Okay, we'll go with this. We shouldn't hear any real change until we get up around these numbers here. Así comentó uno de los aficionados presentes en el estadio Victoria de Girón. Y la Liga Superior de Baloncesto de Gueros manda en capa. Amigos, y con esto de titulares deportivos. Don't fade away now. Principales titulares de la prensa cubana hoy. So the snapping between here and here is a big difference, from almost nothing to 10 times what's in there. I don't hear any difference whatsoever.
Las constantes agresiones de la OEA a la hermana República Bolivariana de Venezuela son analizadas por nuestra periodista Isis María
Ayer. That one actually sounds pretty good.
Una evaluación del comportamiento del secretario general de esa organización, Luis Almagro, por estimular acciones contra la nación sudamericana.
Vamos en las próximas horas, muy próximo.
In the highest setting here. Point two.
El comportamiento del secretario general conforme al mandato de la resolución que nos dieron en la Asamblea General de República Dominicana. Sobre nuestra participación, Venezuela va a...
Don't hear any difference whatsoever. Let's check this capacitor decade box here. Should be 0.1 here to match this.
Donde calificó la postura de Almagro de intervencionista y con apego a los intereses de la derecha de ese partido americano.
Point 0.016. There we are. 0.01. So this is working. 0.01. 0.05.
Low.
0.015 is 0.019. 0.1 is 0.13, so this is working. And the highest setting, 0.22, is actually 0.27, at least on this meter. So this is working fine. The big capacitor made no difference. I'm surprised. I'm really surprised. Hey. Sorry about that. What else is new? Oh, wow. Okay, first plan, down the drain rapidly, unless I need to put an even bigger capacitor in there. I put a 10-timer in there. Didn't do anything. Huh. Okay, you know, I'm looking at the schematic here. There is also a capacitor here, 0.05, coming off the slider. That's this one here. Well, let's boost that guy. 0.05, yeah, I can boost him with this. Okay. So that's 0.05. 0.05 is up in this range, so we shouldn't have any effect till we get around to here. Fading out again. The voice isn't the best thing to do this with either. The voice is not good enough. We need music. We got to find some music here. Very small to the very big on this.
Chastising one of my children, and it would remind me so much of myself. You know, when my parents would chastise me, I had it all planned. Now, the first thing I was going to do was yell. I was going to scream like bloody murder. And in that screaming and yelling, you know, we always make promises.
No difference at all. That's in my perception of that. Got on the bigger setting.
And I got so furious, I just said, I don't even want to hear none of that. I just received the chastisement, just received it. And immediately, he straightened up, and I gave
wow, it's hard to tell with that, isn't it? Wow. Come on, where's some music?
De hecho, los negocios se multiplicaron. Por ejemplo,
Radio China. Twenty-one megahertz. Seventeen. wants to give me any. Okay, you know what? I got to come up with a more objective way of doing this. So I'm going to stop what I'm doing right now, rearrange my test equipment here, and go from using my ears to using an instrument to try to spot changes in things. Good luck to me. Okay, let's give this a go. So, volume turned right down. The radio is not tuned to any station, signal generator, or anything. It's just picking up noise. This is the antenna that it's relying on right now, which really isn't an antenna, but what do we see? You see that hum, which you can hear. I don't know how high I've got the volume set now, straight up. Now we'll tune in the signal generator here. Now that's the sweep generator, sweeping from about 100 hertz up to 1,000. It's a little hard to look at on the screen there. Obviously this is down around 100, and up here it's up around 1,000. Oh, I just wish it was a much smoother looking thing there. Yeah, I don't think that qualifies. That doesn't qualify either. You know, I think I've got a vernier on this. Well, I can't seem to get much of a better image on there. It looks terrible on the camera. What I hope to do now is to see a change down here, but I don't think that's going to happen. Let me make the sweep generator sweep from, instead of 100 to 1,000, 10 to 100. Okay, believe it or not, it's doing it. When I was preparing the last video, last night I was working on it, I noticed that on the video, I could hear lower sounds than I could hear when I was standing here in the shop actually working on things, which I thought was pretty curious. So I wonder if that's happening too. What I hear is a very soft bum 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 bum, fast bum 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 like that. Maybe I turn it up. Turn it up, champ. Why not turn it up? Okay, so you can hear the bum 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 bum. Interesting in itself. Let's add in the extra capacitor here now. Oh, I think this thing is probably, since it's right on the audio input to the amplifier, this is acting now like a noise antenna. Because it's open-ended, as soon as I attach it, that should go away. Across the capacitor. Let me just turn this. It's going to be becoming very sensitive to little charges. That click, in my mind, is a discharge going between me and the radio. Something's building up a bit of a charge here. Well, that made a difference. Now, looking at the signal generator, oh my gosh, how are we ever going to see anything out of that? So the capacitor is set to the largest one here, and I'll just touch this on and off. I'm listening very carefully too. Terrible. This is a terrible way to do this. I'm just introducing so much junk here. Uh, Well, I just have to do what I can. So listening with my ears. Listening, I'm just ignoring the higher buzz, just listening to the lower thumping. There's no difference whatsoever. That's a little better. Take the noise out of there. Let's go back and try this. This might even be noisier back here. Okay, listening and watching. No difference at all. I can't hear any difference whatsoever. What am I concluding? I'm concluding I'm boosting this by a factor of 10. Nothing happens. Boosting this one by a factor of 4. Nothing happens. Barking up the wrong tree here. If I think there's more bass to get, doesn't seem to be appearing. But so either there's some other restriction in the tone somewhere. There is no restriction in the tone, and I'm making this whole thing up. There is a change, but it's inaudible, so who cares? Somebody give me a good station to listen to. I just need a stronger station. What happened there? Well, that's kind of weird. I'll tell you what's weird about it is now, this is just a chassis ground point I keep using here. This clip lead is going to my scope. The scope is three-prong grounded to the power system. This is the lead from my signal generator. It's also got a third prong. Why would applying this ground make it go quiet? I take this one off. Uh-oh, something about the grounding here in my shop that I don't understand. Okay, a little side issue here. What's going on with the grounding of my instruments that this radio can detect some kind of difference? What is going on? Well, I get very concerned about me being aware of how my instruments are working, and from time to time, like almost every day, I find out I don't have it straight. So how can I determine? These are either both connected to the hydro ground, or one is isolated and the other one isn't. How could that even be? No difference. Big difference. Here, I've got another grounded instrument here to try this with. A little side issue here. Another instrument with a three-prong plug. It's my other signal generator. So what is going on here with this particular one? This is the big military signal generator. How's that happen? Still has this quieting effect. Somewhere along the line, I did something. Okay, well, that'll have to stay a mystery. There's something funny about the military. Now, let me try one more thing just before I give up on this little adventure. This is a impedance matching box that's in the output circuit of the signal generator. I'm going to get rid of it. And I can see the ground is connected right through it. I mean, crying out loud. It still goes quiet. Okay, just leave it as one of those things. Maybe someday it'll come to me why that is different. Maybe it boils down to which power bar I've got what instrument plugged into. And once in a while I mention, as I will now, I power the radio with an isolation transformer in the shop here. So every time I connect a power system grounded instrument, I have to think a little bit about what I'm doing. Because I'm introducing a ground that's not there to begin with. This particular radio has a power transformer that provides another level of isolation within the radio. So there's no reference to power system ground, I guess you could say. Something like that. I just said it, so you can say it. So where are we at now? Okay, so plan one just went down the tubes completely. I can't seem to boost the capacitor to overcome some kind of bass tone restriction in the radio. Yet this radio produced more bass. It's got to be a manipulation of the feedback that does that. See if we can tune something in again. Maybe conditions have changed a bit. Somebody's on the air now. Somebody, anybody.
Nació en la tierra ardiente de Santiago de Cuba y se consagró durante muchísimos años a géneros como la salsa, la rumba y también el guaguancó. Vamos a escuchar a esta inigualable cantante Celeste Mendoza en Sobre una tumba, una rumba de el músico Ignacio Piñeiro.
Ah, play some music.
Thank you.
know what? That sounds really good. And now that I'm listening to it, I'm thinking, geez, no, that doesn't really sound that bad. Why do I want to boost the bass on that? Okay, wasn't that an exciting journey of nothing? Journey of nothing. What's next on the hit parade here is to rewire the volume control. Okay, let's. I'm not going to quit here. I got another little capacitor to fiddle with. So if we take a look at the... Actually, I'm going to put this here. Let's put it here. So the next one to fiddle with, since I've disconnected this wire here, and all this feedback signal is no longer making it anywhere, this has all been forsaken, the only feedback is from, make sure, yeah, it's from here, it's from here. Okay, so if you throw the switch in the right position, this connection's made either to here, here, or here, and then it's connected through the small capacitor up to here. Now that small capacitor is this one, right here, 50 picofarad, sticking right out here. It would be easy for me, again, to put the capacitor decade box on it, mess around, see what happens. It just sounds like too much fun to not do it. 50 picofarad would be, wow, maybe smaller than any of the settings on here. Could be, right away. We're going to boost it right away with this box. Now this is the feedback circuit. Come on, Radio Cuba, don't disappear now. You can do it. Come on. Just beam north, straight north. Actually, if you go due south from where I live, let's say you go due south about 2,000 miles, you end up 1,000 miles out in the Pacific Ocean off the coast of South America. No. So don't do that. Here we go. Anything at all happening? Now I've disconnected the scope. Let me reconnect here. So weak. Well, we'll try it here and then we'll try to find something else. So I'm listening for almost any kind of change that might come. I'm assuming by doing this, I'm increasing the amount of feedback. Integrarse de organizaciones no gubernamentales y movimientos sociales marcarán este nuevo contrato. I don't hear the slightest change. It's the biggest setting I've got. Wow, every idea is going in the dumper here. That's not changing anything any which way. Let's try it with a little more volume.
El primer vicepresidente del Partido Socialista Unido de Venezuela, Gustavo Cabello, ha descrito la concentración convocada por sectores de la derecha para que se desembaraca por la continuación de la fiscal. En declaraciones a medio 70, el dirigente socialista reveló un documento de Avares por miembros de la denominada Mesa de Unidad en nuestro plan de impulsar acciones violentas en las calles. De acuerdo con la denuncia, el plan contempla atacar instituciones públicas con las sedes del Tribunal Federal de la Justicia, Defensoría del Pueblo y Consejo Nacional Electoral.
So what I hear happening is I can hear a high frequency hiss and come in when I connect this. I increase the capacitance is way up above what it is.
Se adhirió a las acciones de impugnación que se presentaron por sus opositores en movimiento Carechoma. En declaraciones a medios de prensa, la secretaria ejecutiva de Solís y el asambleísta José Serrano subrayaron que el propósito de Alianza País es evitar la fuga.
But I can't hear any change in pitch of the program material. It's just a man talking, so where'd that music go? Somewhere Cuba's got a booming signal coming in up here, somewhere. Let's go find it. Something exciting go on in my shop here.
De los trabajadores de la educación, la ciencia y el deporte, debatió sobre la superación política y ideológica de los dirigentes sindicales cubanos. Olga Lidia Tapia, miembro del secretariado del Comité Central del Partido Comunista de Cuba, subrayó la importancia de la constante capacitación de los cuadros del gremio, basado en el estable líder de la revolución Fidel Castro. También insistió en la necesidad de elevar la calidad del proceso de centro educativo y mantener motivados a los profesionales del magisterio formadores de las nuevas generaciones. El director de la Sociedad Teórica de Chile, José Cabello, resaltó que Latinoamérica es un lugar privilegiado en cuanto a recursos minerales y los países deben explotarlos de forma sustentable. Considero Cabello capacitado.
Yeah, I'm just standing here thinking. Well, maybe I've just beat this whole thing to death here. There's really no way I can dramatically improve the sound quality. It actually sounds pretty good anyway, so maybe I'm actually chasing something that's not there to be found. Although yesterday I was definitely left convinced that... The reason I was left convinced that was because in some of these settings, some of the settings on this, the bass was definitely louder. Now maybe it was getting, maybe I did some kind of bass boost technique using feedback, and maybe even using feedback that's slightly out of phase at low frequencies. Maybe somehow that results in a bass boost. And maybe the theory put forward by one of you about this being a problem of avoiding patented tone controls, and they've come up with this other way of affecting the tone using feedback, and boom, maybe they even patented this. I have no idea. I think that's it. I don't think I can do any more for this radio on the audio side. All my ideas have gone down the drain. The last one was to connect the volume control right to the ground. Why would I even try this? And it's working fairly well. Now, you do see on the scope, there is some kind of a thing there. I can't hear that. You don't hear that coming out of the... You know, that could just be an artifact of my leads or something like that. Yeah, never mind what I was just saying about the scope. It's not even connected to anything, so there you are. Good. Okay. I think alignment is next.